When Fermat discovered a subtle method to determine whether a number is prime or composite, his peers couldn't comprehend the purpose or potential use of the proof. The proof, for most of its existence, was perceived like a piece of art, beautiful but practically useless. In fact, discoveries regarding prime numbers were venerated simply for the achievement of discovery, but they didn't contribute any substantial solutions to problems in the real world. However, 400 years later, the internet was born, and the privacy of billions of users now relies heavily on prime numbers. Prime numbers are commonly referred to as the atoms of the numerical realm, for they are the fundamental, indivisible units that make up every number. For instance, 10 can be written as a product of 2 and 5, two prime numbers. 150 as a product of 15 and 10, which can be further broken down and written as the product of 3, 5, 2, and 5, all prime numbers. The process of reducing a composite number to a product of prime numbers is known as prime factorization. For a computer, multiplying two prime numbers, even if they are both 100 digits long, isn't very difficult. However, factorizing the product back into its components is notoriously difficult, even for supercomputers. It is this shortcoming that Rivest, Shamir, and Edelman exploited to create RSA encryption in 1977. In cryptography jargon, this unidirectionality is known as a trapdoor. Let's say that C is the product of two prime numbers, P and Q. While encrypting your credit card details, for example, the number C is used to generate the public key. This key, as its name suggests, is available to the public, meaning that it can be intercepted and read by anyone in the network. A public key secures private information by locking it in a box, whose handles are tightly clasped with a several hundred-digit combination lock. The box itself can be accessed by anyone, but the content inside cannot be reached. While a thief may furtively steal the box, he can't unlock it without knowing the combination, without possessing the private key. This private key is only possessed by the sender and receiver of the content, the bank, and you, the owner of the credit card. The private key constitutes the two prime numbers, P and Q, that were multiplied to produce C, the public key. Without their knowledge, the thief would have to factorize C, which could take thousands of years if the numbers are hundreds of digits long. And there are a lot of massively large prime numbers. One of the largest is 2 raised to the power of 43,112,609 subtracted by 1. If you were to write this number on a piece of paper, it would take you a total of 4,376 pages to completely write out the sequence. Factorization is not impossible, it is just exorbitantly time-consuming. As technology progresses, you might be able to crunch numbers more quickly. Quantum computers might be highly successful in achieving this, but currently, we have years and probably decades before they reach that level of sophistication and speed. If you enjoyed this video, we'd love to hear from you in the comments section. Your feedback not only supports us, but also helps our channel reach more viewers and continue to grow.